Hey guys! So today I'm here to talk to you about binge eating. If you followed and listened to my last videos, you would have heard where I was talking about depriving myself on a diet and losing a lot of weight really fast, but having it not work out for me because after depriving myself for so long, when I finally did have something sweet or something that was unhealthy, I ended up binge eating. So that day that I ended up binge eating, I ate way more than I needed to, of course, because I binged. I ate lots of cake, chocolate, sweets. It was Easter, so all the stuff was around, and in Portuguese, so there was plenty at the table. I got home that day and I was so sick, like I could not stop vomiting, but that didn't matter because I went so long without it, and I love sweets. When I binged that day, even though I got sick, I still ended up in a binging cycle for almost 2 years. Like, it was rough. This is why when I make meal plans for people, I don't deprive them of any nutrients. So if you're looking for a very specific diet, I guess I'm not your person because I make plans where there's balance in your life. So I follow whole foods diets where you can eat anything. And I follow that 70 to 30, 80 to 20% rule based on the person and where they're starting. So back to my story, I ended up in the binging cycle for about 2 years. So after that day, I binged. The rest of that year looked like for me, 1 week I'd eat really healthy and I would go to the gym 4 to 5 times a week, feel really good about myself. And then the next week, all of a sudden something would spark and I would end up binge eating and sitting on the couch the rest of the day. Go to school, go to work, come home, eat like crap and do nothing. There's no gym. It was just me feeling like garbage, my stomach being constantly upset, no energy. And although I felt this way, it was such a problem that I had that I just couldn't give it up. So even though those weeks that I was going to the gym, I was feeling so great, or at least I thought, because I was depriving myself still within that week when I was working out, I really wasn't feeling that good, which is why I would end up binging the following week and feeling like garbage, just because I would eat way too much instead of allowing myself once or twice a week to have one treat. So not a whole cake, but like maybe a slice. That was when I would have felt good, as if I was doing that, which is now currently how my diet is. So now I'm able to maintain my level of fitness and keep improving, becoming more and more athletic. But my weight is no longer fluctuating. I'm able to maintain it and lose at a steady rate. And my mentality is a lot healthier. I feel good about myself. I like to inspire others and share with them my story just because I've gone through so much when it comes to health and fitness that I really learned a lot to help educate people. So once I was going through that year of binging, I ended up gaining back all that weight that I lost when I first deprived myself for like 3 months straight. And I actually gained back more weight than I had even lost. So started at 185 pounds when I began to deprive myself, and I ended up going up to 190. This started to become a huge problem because my family was noticing that I was eating a lot of garbage and doing nothing 1 week, and then the other week I'm like going to the extreme. And they also noticed me gain weight, so they started bringing it to my attention and asking me what I was going to do about it and trying to helped me realize that obviously what I was doing wasn't working. So instead of taking that as positive feedback, what I ended up doing is I would eat really healthy all week and all day and work out every week. So thinking I'm on this good track again, but then what I would do is I would binge eat when everyone was asleep. So I would go to bed around 9, 10 at night, which I still do, sometimes 11 if I'm really pushing it. And then I would wake up at like midnight, 3 or 4 in the morning. I would go eat all the junk food, like half a pack of cookies. Like, it was insane, the things that I was eating, ice cream. And it got to the point where like my family was really concerned about me. They'd wake up in the middle of the night and they would like ask me to go back to bed, ask me what I was doing, why I was eating at that time, and especially those things. But it still didn't matter. They would wake up every day, it wouldn't even matter. I'd still wake up as well and I'd still eat those things. So I ended up being at that point where I was like 190 pounds and just feeling so down on myself. I had no control at all. All I wanted to do was eat crap. Of course, before I started to deprive myself, that was my diet. I would eat sweets, fast food, microwave dinners all the time. It's what I lived off. I was really unhealthy and I looked, felt, and was that way. But even when I started this journey, because I didn't have that mental strength, I was still very weak, and I got lost and stuck on these paths of binge eating or deprivation for so long because I just wasn't sure what to do. So it all changed for me, actually, when I met my boyfriend. I started sleeping at his house, and I didn't want to wake up in the middle of the night and eat all of his food. So I would just sleep all night, even though I was starving. I'd wake up and I'd grab water or something instead. And also, I met my boyfriend in a fitness and health promotion program we were both taking at college. So I learned a lot through that program about nutrition, about motivational interviewing, and behavior change. So I was able to make real goals for myself, and everything shifted with that. I met some people in my life at that time as well that helped open me up spiritually. So I came into this health journey with a very, very low self-esteem. I had many walls built up inside of me that it was really hard for me to communicate with people because I was just so closed off at that time. That when I met these people that were very spiritual, I spent a lot of time with them. I was there every week, a few times a week, and they would be performing Reiki on me and giving me all these positive affirmations, telling me I'm a good person, reminding me that like daily, like several times a day, like, you're a good person, Chelsea, you're so good, you're awesome. And asking me to repeat this to myself over and over again. So that's what I did. I told myself that I'm a good person, told myself I love myself, and I just kept telling myself these things until like it really started to resonate with me and I felt it. Like I felt like I love myself and I was happy. I felt like I had something to live for. Like I'm a good person, I can do so much. And that's really when I started to believe that my health was changing as well. I ended up dropping down from 190 pounds down to now 145, and I've been able to maintain that. When I deprived myself, I was down at 135 pounds as my lowest, but I wasn't really doing a lot of weight training then, so I lost the weight, but I had a lot of extra skin, I wasn't as strong or as muscular as I now am, and I didn't feel as good. I looked sick, now I look healthy, I feel healthy. I didn't love myself then, now I do. And I've just made it my goal to teach people how to love themselves as well and how to have a healthy relationship with themselves, with the food they eat, with the exercise they do, and yeah, just really becoming engaged with themselves and nature. Nature is another really big part of my journey. I make it a goal for myself to go hiking at least once a week. Usually I get out more than that just because I love being outside. But yeah, hiking definitely helped change my life. So I'm always trying to inspire and push my clients to spend more time outside in nature. You don't have to know lots about nature to enjoy it. Like, I'm really educated in plants and trees. It's part of my side job. So I'm a seasonal adventure guide and I take people down the river, kayaking or canoeing, whatever they choose. And then I also take them on hikes and teach them about the plants and trees in our area. So for me, it's a huge part of my life as well because I'm very connected to what's around me. I know what's safe to eat, and that's actually what helped me start eating healthier foods. At that point when I was depriving myself, I was eating a lot of foods from my garden, like weeds that were growing in the grass that I knew were edible. So yeah, that's why my business name is Full Health Chelsea as well, as I try to encompass all of health into my training. So nature, spirituality, exercise, and nutrition, and really establishing strong mental health, because through my experience, once you are able to become mentally strong and love yourself, that is when the real shift in your life happens. Especially for people that are very empathetic and care a lot for others and are always wanting to help others become happy. If you don't love yourself first, you're not going to be able to make other people happy or as happy as you can if you love yourself and are happy with yourself. Sure, you'll be able to help other people without having that self-love, but when you have that strong base inside and you really feel good about yourself, others see it and that alone will help them. I have so many people now tell me that like, I'm so positive, I'm so bright. It's not even that they want to come in and work out with me. Like, they love my workouts, but they just love being around me. And that alone helps them. So people that are really depressed that work out with me, just feeling my energy makes them feel better. For the rest of their day. I've had people tell me before that are on meds for depression.